It's so funny because there is this perception out there that LeBron James has been doing this alone. Now, you can probably make that argument when you look at, you know, what happened in the series against the Indiana Pacers. That was a gritty series that went down to the wire. You know, a game seven for LeBron. He needed a buzzer beater in one of those games. But when it comes to what we've seen in the NBA's Eastern Conference semis, that whole LeBron is doing this on his own is out the window. But, you know, it's been the national perception. It really has. Because LeBron is throwing up these crazy numbers, and he continued to capitalize on those numbers in the four-game sweep of the Toronto Raptors. But you look at production from other players. I mean, my goodness, Kevin Love averaging 20.5 points in the sweep of the Raptors. Kyle Korver averaging 14.5 points per game. J.R. Smith averaging almost 13 points per game. And, you know, you look at both J.R. and Korver, both of them shot 55%, and Smith shot 76% from three-point land. So LeBron isn't doing this by himself. That production from his teammates has really propelled the Cavs, in my estimation. And now they'll move on to play what is likely to be the Boston Celtics, who did fall to the Philadelphia 76ers last night. But let's be real here. I don't think there's any way that Philly's going to come back in that series against the Celtics. So it'll probably be Boston versus the Cavs. The Cavs are going to be highly favored in that series. And I'm curious to see if that production from LeBron's teammates does continue. But you know what? I want to play a snippet. As I mentioned earlier in the hour, SNL, they did not release this skit during Donald Glover's hosting debut on SNL Saturday night this past weekend. But it's a skit that has been released, and it was cut due to time. But it was released on social media, and you can check it out on SNL's YouTube page. But it is pretty hilarious, and it kind of puts in perspective and really reiterates that national perception that LeBron James is doing this solo dolo. But how funny is that? Did you get a chance to check it out since you've been behind the glass, Ian? That's golden, right?
Yeah, that's fantastic. I especially like the hot potato comment from Keenan Mitchell.
Yeah, Keenan is so funny. Out of the entire cast, I would probably have to say that Keenan is my favorite just because he kills it every single skit. You know what I mean? And he's been in SNL. I think he's the longest tenured cast member out of the entire roster right now.
Yeah, definitely out of the remaining group.
Exactly, out of the remaining
group.
And
did you watch him on All That in the 90s?
I did. You know, that again, that's why we have a personal connection when it comes to Kenan Thompson, because he was on All That, and not just that, he was also on Kenan and Kel with Kel Mitchell back in the day on Nickelodeon. So hilarious, though. But you know what? I think, and you know, I saw this retweeted by many people last night. But you look at that skit, right? And looking at a report, I saw a report that was floating out there that one of the Cleveland Cavalier players decided to not go out and play. Rodney Hood refused to enter the game when summoned in the fourth quarter on Monday, angering a number of teammates. That's according to multiple sources. And maybe he saw that SNL skit. Because let's be real, if you're a teammate of LeBron James, and you hear the national conversation, and you see that SNL skit, that's got to irk you. That's got to tick you off just a little bit. If you're Kevin Love, you know, if Rodney Hood, J.R. Smith, you got to be a little bit angered, right, Ian? I mean, come on. They're saying that you don't contribute and help out. Yet, I just mentioned all the contributors to this sweep of the Toronto Raptors for the Cavs.
Well, even if you just look at LeBron's stat line alone, I mean, he's scoring 40 points, but he's given out 15 to 20 assists per game. So that right there tells you that he's not doing it all by himself, because he's got to get to a triple-double somehow.
Definitely. I hear you.
He's not going to get it in turnovers.
Nonetheless, comedy gold, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, good one from SNL there. I wish that one had made the cut.
I wish so, too, for sure. But again, you can check it out on SNL's YouTube page. All right, we're out of time, folks.